Teenage Mutant Ninja Santona. Oh, do I love me some TMNT, and I love me some TFs. And when they're combined, they merge together in a holy matrimony of goodness. And we got Party Wallop. So it's going to become the Turtle Van, and it can make any of the four Ninja Turtles here. Now, so if you wanted to get four separately, you got to buy this times four. Comes with all the weapons for all the different turtles and all the different masks. So if you want four of them, you got to buy it four times. Let's first check out the accessories. You got this stuff, and then a whole bunch of this to make up all of your characters. Here he is, Party Wallop, walloping in the vehicle mode. He's a little bit not tabbed together. I have a hard time keeping all the stuff together here. When I plug in certain things, other things want to kind of pop out, and that just might be me and my lack of being good at this. So yeah, that's it. But it looks amazing, man. It looks pretty cool. Loving the turtle van. There he is from the back. It's the Party Wallop, man. This is cool. And I love the feel of this plastic. It's nice and heavy. It's that heavy stuff. Remember the old school X-Men crossovers that they had, like Wolverine and Hulk and Captain America? They were nice and big and heavy and hefty, and that's what this feels like. And that's a welcome addition to this dude's collection. At this point, if you care, this is how he looks next to other vehicles. And there it is with some other stuff I've got laying around. Okay, time to fiddle and play. First thing I'm going to do is, because these things always pop off, these little lights and whatever these little sign things are, they come off. So we'll do that. We'll take those off. Also, these things like to pop off too. These are obviously Leonardo's swords. And I'm pretty sure they're supposed to go this way. Like that, so it kind of go like hides in the swoop of this vehicle, but I can't get it to do that. I don't know why. It just won't. It doesn't. So whatever. And then you can pull this off too. This is an extra piece that we will take and put aside. Now here's the coolness, man. We're gonna start unfurling this thing, and we'll do it piece by piece because, man, it's cool, and it's a lot of fun. A lot of fun, this transformation, even for big hands old McGee right here, who's really typically pretty horrible at this stuff. I can manage this one. So you can see what's going on here. And then you see the two side. We're going to take those off his legs. And we'll pull this all apart. Let's see if we can get... There we go. There we go. We'll separate the arms tab into the legs in the back, which is pretty neat. And we're trying to get that untabbed. Oh, does it tab in tightly? Oh, my word! Is that tight? So tolerancing... pretty stellar on this guy. Let's see if we can get this in a way that I can show it off. Oh yeah, this comes off too, this whole bumper piece. So this is kind of like a shield weapon, but it does make up the whole front of this vehicle. And then you can use it as a shield too. This comes down, you can plug it into the arm. Check this out, the little Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle wheel cover thing here. It says the name on it. You flip it around, look at that, pepperoni pizza. Gonna just continue mutilating this guy. And what you want to do here is you pull these down. These become like little hip things, little hip armor pieces, I guess. You can flip down the heel spurs here. You can flip down his feet like this. This is Party Wallop. And under here, you can see you pull his head up. Let's get his arms in front first. And we'll flip these to the sides for now. We'll just do that. I guess we can flip. I guess we could just continue the whole thing because I'm just kind of doing it. But you can see under here, it's storage for all the different head types, the masks, which makes him a different turtle. Get his plane head popped up there. That looks neat. He's got it's on a ball joint. Look at the teeth. I love when my Transformers have teeth, white teeth, man. Been going to the dentist. I love it. And you can kind of put his, kind of arrange his armor as you see fit. He does have some extra chunks of armor kind of hanging off of him, but it doesn't look bad. It looks kind of neat. And I don't know, guys, what do you think? Let's start off with, making Raphael. Also to note here, there are spots where you can store weaponry wherever you like, all over this guy. It fits in all different places. So if you don't want him in his hands, you just stick them all over him. And this doesn't necessarily pertain to any one of the turtles, but you can plug this into his arm, and now he's got a shield. Something pretty cool here. In the shoulder pauldrons, as you can see, we have a couple of nunchucks. So let's do Mikey next. Okay, we got that guy out. We'll give him the nunchuck in his hand. He can swing that around. That's kind of neat. And we got the top of Mikey's head. We will plug that down. And now we have Michelangelo. He's got two sets of nunchuck, as you can see. And I will pull these out, put this back. And of course, you can store all these weapons too. You could do it in both modes, right? So if you're not in Michelangelo mode, you can store the scythe, store the bow, store all the other heads. You can hide them away right on him, which is really neat. So that's a cool thing. And now we've got Michelangelo with his nunchuck. Next up, we have Donatello, and he has a weapon that falls apart in your hands. Not supposed to do that, but there is his bow with horrible visible hinges. You guys know how much I hate those hinges. Man, I'll tell you, that looks weak. This one looks weak sauce. But I'm pretty sure you can get just a straight up bow that doesn't look like that on any other toy and stick it in his hand and be fine. So there is Donatello mode. And lastly, probably my favorite, I guess if I had to pick one, it'd probably be Leo. I don't know why. I mean, he's got swords, so I think that's the coolest of the weapons. Two katanas, and I like blue. His personality is kind of weak sauce. I kind of like Raphael's personality myself. But he's got, I think, the cooler weapons, and I like blue better than red. So, I don't know. I guess I'm a Leo fan. One last bit of business, too. They do have belt buckle. He's got a belt buckle, right? And you can kind of cycle between the letters and the corresponding colors. So whenever mode you choose, they've got a matching belt buckle. Look at that. So guys, there's a ton of playability with this thing. I absolutely dig both properties. I love crossover stuff. As hokey as sometimes that is, this one's really, really good, man. I think it's pretty cool. I love all the accessories that they give you for this. These things are just a little too pricey for me. I wish they were 15 bucks cheaper, maybe 20 bucks cheaper, and I would definitely get all four. From the price point alone, I don't think I will hunt down another three of these things, but if I can catch them on sale, I may pick them up just so I can have four of them. I'll have them dedicated to each one of the turtle personas, and that would be cool. Comparison time! Couple more. And that ought to do it. That's going to wrap it up for me, folks. I'm Mitch Santoro. We just saw Party Wallop, the big old crossover with Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Very, very cool. Very, very fun. I like this guy a lot. I think you would like it, too, especially if you're a fan of either one of these franchises. Big win here from Hasbro. The only thing I got to say, like, I don't like is this right here. Too much of this. Lower the cost a little bit. I buy three more of these things. I'll see you guys in the next one. Arrivederci, babies. Have a good one.